Hey everybody, good evening. Welcome back to Logic Rex. It's been quite a while. This is actually, I think this might be the first time I'm doing a recorded video in quite a while. Unfortunately, this is not a happy video or a positive one. I mean, I hope my words can mean something or that there is a purpose to recording this. Came across a video tonight. It was posted this morning. This is originally from TimCast Jason Jones. I don't know who this gentleman is here depicted, but what we're about to watch is pretty concerning. And like the title says, I can no longer remain silent. I suppose I'll preface this with saying I am a transitioning male. I am in my early 30s, full-grown adult. What I decide to do with my body is my decision. In the bigger picture of things, I can no longer remain silent when I see individuals of my community claiming to speak on my behalf or claiming that they are defending me or saving me when they are in fact doing the opposite. I would like to read this tweet real quick. What I'm about to show you is pretty concerning. It might elicit some negative emotions. I would caution the viewers. So, I dare you to try and stop me from going into a woman's bathroom. It will be the last mistake you ever make. This is a call to action and a call to arms. This is a very short TikTok. I'm going to try to make this video as quick, as concise, as contextualized as I possibly can. As fast as I can. I'm not trying to draw this thing out. I want to try to employ logic and reason to help. I don't know. Let's just start it.
I know I usually start these with something funny, but I really can't with this. This is nuts.
So you go ahead, you protect your kids from me using the bathroom. If you back a wild animal into a corner, they're going to become a dangerous animal.
Okay, let's pause it right there. Alrighty. As you can see, the individual already compared themselves to a dangerous wild animal. I'm not going to pull any punches here. This video made me livid. When I saw this person speaking the way that they were and using the terminology that he did, because I'm not going to mix words here. This is a male. In no way, shape, or form is that trans. Please tell me what's trans about this individual. What? They grew their hair out? They're wearing what is that, a stud earring? What is that, a feminine stud, or are they wearing feminine clothing? This is not a trans person, in my opinion. This is a male man, objectively. Man, there's nothing feminine about this person. Not even like zero. There's zero attempt here to appear feminine aside from what, long hair? That's not feminine. What could, because you got your hair draped to the side. Like this video, this asshat really, lack of a better wording, pissed me off when I saw this.
So if you want to die on that hill of yours of righteousness and moral majority, then you go right ahead.
Very interesting wording he picked there. Moral majority. Now, I think some people, there's a debate about subjective versus objective morality. I don't think this person is clear-headed. I believe this person to be very extremely emotional and unhinged in their rhetoric. The terming and phrasing that they're using is totally void of anything that could be considered to be reasonable or sane.
I dare you to try and stop me from going into a women's bathroom. It will be the last mistake you ever make.
How old is this transgender versus like women's bathroom thing? How old is this debate, and how much longer is it going to go on for? This is beyond inflammatory. It's beyond irresponsible for this person. What I would argue is making a legitimate threat.
I dare you to try and stop a transgender woman in my presence from using the bathroom. It will be the last mistake you ever make.
Okay. I'm going to say this straight up. I don't think there's many people. There is not many people who is remotely afraid of this marshmallow. In my opinion, this man doesn't appear even fit or physically capable of fighting his way out of a wet paper bag. This person, I don't know what kind of training they have. I don't know who on God's green earth this guy thinks he is, but I'm just saying he ain't. And I'm not sure if this person realizes what kind of target that he just put on his back. I'm full well believe that there are so many parents that have watched this video, because this will probably go viral. I expect this TikTok to go viral at least by tomorrow. It is the last mistake you'll ever make. That is a literal threat. In my opinion, what this person just said does constitute a threat. That if you are somebody who attempts to stop a transgender woman from going into the bathroom, restroom, in his presence, it will be the last mistake you ever make. In my opinion, that's a threat. And a bold one at that. Like I said, I don't think there's many people, especially parents, that have even a notion or a modicum of fear when looking at a marshmallow like this.
This is a call to action and a call to arms. You need to arm up.
Call to action and a call to arms over transgender women being stopped from using a restroom. Number one, who has a right to a restroom? I mean, maybe in a public facility, in a government facility, but in a private business, what if the private business doesn't allow that? What if the private business and the business owner says, you know what, trans women ain't using the woman's bathroom, use the men's room? What are you going to do then? What is this moron going to do? What are you going to open up on the business owner? Is that going to be the last mistake the business owner ever makes if this individual tries to use the woman restroom in a private business that doesn't allow that? What are you going to do? I don't think he's going to do a damn thing. I think he's making a legit threat, but I really don't think he's going to go through with it. I don't think this person really, really understands the gravity of what he is saying. I think this person was just very emotional and unhinged in the moment and really just did not think about making that video. Did like this is not indicative of someone who has their thoughts collectively arranged in a reasonable manner.
Plain and simple, go out, buy a gun, learn how to use it, efficiently through and through, because the time to act is now, as I'm going to do myself.
The time to act is now, as he's going to do himself. What is he going to do after making a call to arms, or a call to action? So he's advocating for trans people to go out and buy firearms? I mean, in the bigger picture, I do support everybody's Second Amendment right to go out, purchase a firearm, learn how to use it for self-defense in the event that somebody is trying to do imminent physical harm to your life and person, or someone that you love in the immediate area. Self-defense, legitimate self-defense, is only to save your life when being aggressed upon physically, an action that will land you in the hospital, that will put your life in jeopardy. There's an argument to say that some, you know, will defend their private property in the incident, for example, of an armed robbery, but that's still putting your life at risk, where the threat of violence is legitimate, that you may lose your life. Being stopped from using a restroom is not grounds for self-defense in any state, in any logical realm of this reality. There is no world where this person will open fire on somebody for stopping a trans woman from using the women's restroom and them getting away with it. It's not going to happen. I mean, say what you want about, you know, New York State and California, that who knows when it comes to these crazy kind of states like this. But I would be hard pressed to ever believe that someone can legitimately commit murder, because that's what that would be. If this person were to open fire or draw their firearm and take the life of somebody else because they stopped a trans woman from using a restroom, he's going straight to jail for the rest of his life. And you know what? If that's his decision, he's an idiot. He's an asshat. And I full send condemn this whole thing. I want there to be a purpose to this video. And I want to keep this very short,
because there are lots of people like me who are not afraid to die. I love my girlfriends to death, but I would rather die for them to secure their safety, freedom, and future.
Yeah, see, nah, girl. Nah, sis. You ain't securing nothing. You're just making everything worse for your own community and your own girlfriends. I don't know what world this person thinks that he's in. It's like he has a full send martyr complex. He has a savior complex that he's trying to project on the entire community, which is including me. And I'm going to absolutely condemn this person. I don't agree with anything that this individual says. I mean, barring from me being a libertarian, because in the context of the private business, I full send believe that if a private business didn't want to allow me to use the woman's restroom, I would have to deal with that and accept it and be like, okay, I'll either use the men's restroom or hopefully there'd be a unisex restroom. This whole restroom argument is beaten beyond recognition. How much longer are we going to have this debate? It just makes no sense. The trans community needs to figure something out with these restrooms. Like, either crowdsource, fund some unisex restrooms. If there's a private business, a local business in a trans community, like, private businesses should just be building unisex restrooms. I realize that's easier said than done, and this whole debate is drawn out and it's tired as heck. But with somebody like this coming out, My first thought when I heard this person, and I watched the whole video, and I had to watch it a couple times to actually believe that somebody had this garbage coming out of their mouth, I immediately thought of a parent and a child in a woman's restroom, mother and daughter in the woman's restroom. This man walks in and the mother is uncomfortable and attempts to stop this individual from being in the woman's restroom, asks, you know, tells him to leave, or like, can you please wait until me and my daughter get out of here so you can go live in your special fairy tale world where you think you're a woman, because you're not. Trans women ain't women. There's plenty of us that agree with that. I'm not a woman. I'll never be a woman. And it's time for people like this person on TikTok here to accept that, because they're just making it worse for everybody. I'm really, really getting tired of these people. And like I said, no longer silent. I'm done. I'm full send done with asshats like this. I'm so beyond livid with this individual.
Than to live and not have anything done.
All right. So that was it for this moron.
I know I usually...
I don't even want to look at their face anymore. Oh, I just wanted to put... This was my statement. I already spoke out about it. This is by far one of the most irresponsible statements on behalf of the trans community that I've seen thus far. This is infuriating. This paints a horrible picture of both the trans and gun-owning communities, which it absolutely does. These are two communities that are really in the crosshairs right now. Crosshairs. Pun not intended. The trans community is super vilified. The gun-owning community, super vilified right now. This is wholly irresponsible of a statement for this person to put out. What this person was thinking is beyond me. Whoever that is, their statement needs to be full send condemned. Wholeheartedly condemn that statement. I'm pretty sure this video is going to be making the rounds tomorrow. And like I said, I couldn't remain silent on it, guys. Again, the first thing I thought to myself is, what if there's parents? Let's think about, let's put it simply, mother and a father are in the restroom. Mother, father, daughter. Out on the restaurant, right? Mother and daughter go to the woman's restroom. Father sees that asshat attempt to go into the woman's bathroom and tries to stop him. I don't even want to get close to that thought because of how angry it makes me to think that somebody from my community would take the life. Literally take a life over being stopped from using a restroom that they're not even, they have no right to use that restroom. There's no inherent right to a restroom. Please point to me where in the Constitution is that anyone has a right to a restroom. I'm so tired of this, and I'm so tired of these people owning the conversation. Claiming to speak for me as an individual. That person doesn't speak for me or for anybody else. That marshmallow can go fly a kite, for a better lack of a term. Stick it where the sun don't shine. I'm sick and tired of it, and I'm done. No longer silent. You know what? I think that's enough said.